So today, Insurgency Sandstorm got updated to version 1.4, giving us a new map, new weapons, and a new game mode, as well as a complete overhaul to the matchmaking system. So obviously, there's a lot to talk about in this one. So guys, this is Billy Eat World again, and let's find out. Alright, so there is so much to talk about in this patch, it's not funny. So let's kick off with the most obvious thing that you're going to notice, which is the brand new snow map called Hillside, which if you're a veteran of Insurgency 2014, you'll actually probably remember as the map called Sinjar, which back then was one of the most popular maps in the game. This one is currently available for all of the versus game modes and for all of the co-op game modes as well, and there's even some special Hillside playlists available this week so you can try it out. And not just that, but there's also some special winter themed cosmetics that have been added in this update as well, which are probably a great idea if you want to stay hidden on this new map. Now, speaking of game modes, well, another new addition in this update is called Frontline, which is basically just like Push, except the flow of gameplay can actually switch around. Essentially, you don't just attack or defend a single objective in this one anymore, you'll actually have to do both at the same time. For fans of Push though, well, another big piece of news you want to know about is 1.4 also includes a new playlist type called Ground Battle, which includes both Push and Frontline. And for fans of Firefight and Skirmish, well, there's another playlist for you guys as well called Point Capture, joining up both of these modes, which should give you a bit more variety in your play sessions. Now, speaking of playlists, well, here's where this update starts to get interesting, because not only have they introduced map voting to official servers, they've also completely changed how matchmaking works. For example, you've probably figured out by now that the devs are introducing a system of new playlists, which, like I said, combine similar themed maps and modes. The main thing about this new playlist system though is that not every playlist is going to be a permanent feature in the game, and some will rotate in and out. But apparently there is going to be at least one limited time playlist for both versus and co-op in the game at any time, and apparently they could turn over on as often as a weekly basis. For example, like I said, this week we've got some limited time playlists focused on Hillside, and you'd have to imagine that in future updates, we'll have some playlists to showcase that new content as well. But not just that, apparently we're also going to get limited time game modes that feature regular maps and modes, but with special mutators, like for example, snipers or headshots only. According to the devs, they won't, quote, necessarily be as unique or fully produced as arcade modes like Frenzy Checkpoint or Team Deathmatch, but they will come much more rapidly. And not just that, but apparently these mutators will also be available on community servers. So who knows, maybe some server admins will end up making them a permanent feature on their servers anyway. But finally, the last big new addition you'll notice in this update is that the Gunner class now has got some new weapons, the Galil for the Insurgent team and the Galil SAR for the Security team. And basically, as you can see, both of these guns are a smaller, more mobile LMG for the class, kind of more similar to an assault rifle. Now, with that being said, you can still customize these weapons with drum mags if you want to use them like a regular LMG to lock down lanes, but they're obviously going to be a bit more forgiving on the move. And obviously, they're not going to probably be as good as either an assault rifle or an LMG for their specific roles, but unfortunately, that's the price that you pay for versatility. Now, to finish up, the last thing I want to mention is that if you are serious about understanding the weapon meta in this game, it's probably actually worth taking a look at the patch notes for this one, because it does look like the devs have hit a lot of weapons pretty hard with the Nerf Bat, especially when it comes to supply cost, so you might find that you need to change around some of your favorite loadouts. Also, as well as weapon balance changes, there's also been a ton of other fixes and improvements, and all in all, I've got to say the game is probably running better now than it's ever run before. And look, I've got to admit, while I was playing today, I did come across a few little graphical artifacts, some of which you probably can see in this video, but all in all, I was getting a pretty stable frame rate most of the time, which is a huge improvement from only a few months ago. But anyway, guys, that just about wraps up this quick update video. So as always, make sure you let me know what you think in the comment section down below. And of course, just remember that I can't possibly cover everything in this update in just this one video. So if you do want some more info, make sure you check out the full patch notes, which I'll link in the description down below. As always, though, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and please feel free to check out the links in the description if you want to see any more of these videos. And don't forget, you can find my Twitter and Discord links down there as well if you want to keep in touch. And as always, until next time, see you later, and have a good one.